The council-manager form of government was created in the early part of the 20th century as a product of the Progressive Reform Movement. The Progressive Reform Movement was a national political movement motivated to destroy monopoly power. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, progressive leaders attacked economic monopoly power by leading efforts to enact antitrust laws, like the Sherman Antitrust Act, the Clayton Antitrust Act, and the Wheeler-Lea Act. The progressives were also interested in breaking up monopoly political power. Consequently, they formed third parties to challenge the monopoly of the two major parties. They were also active within the two parties themselves, developing innovations such as the direct primary as a means of loosening the grip of party bosses on the party organizations. Finally, and most important for our purposes, they advocated weakening mayors in some American cities who had come to function as political bosses with the innovation of the council-manager form of government. The council-manager form of government is the most common form of municipal government among Texas's large and medium-sized cities. In this form of city government, there is, in principle, a clear distinction between the policy-making and administrative functions of city government. The City Council is the policy-making body responsible for making decisions about the city budget and city services. The City Manager, who is hired by the City Council as a professional to be the City's Chief Operating Officer, is responsible for the efficient and effective operation of the city departments that administer city services. The motivation of the Council-Manager form of municipal government is to extract politics from the administration of city services by taking control of administration out of the hands of an elected politician, the mayor, and placing it under the professional management of an appointed official, the city manager. There is usually a mayor in this form of city government who may appear on the ballot as a separately elected position or may be selected by the members of the city council from among their own ranks. In either case, the mayor is little more than a ceremonial position and is the parliamentary officer who presides over council meetings, managing the flow of agenda items. In the council-manager form of government, the council creates, organizes, and structures city departments, approves the city budget, establishes the local property tax rate, enacts local laws called ordinances, and most importantly for our discussion, hires the city manager. The city manager administers the city departments on a day-to-day basis, hires assistant city managers and department heads, supervises city staff, and translates policy directives into concrete plans of action for the city departments to follow. Though it is not a formal function of the city manager, as a matter of political reality, however, often the city manager or the manager's staff develops policy proposals for the council to consider. Thus, the idea that the city manager is an official who is completely removed from local political pressures is not very realistic. Indeed, successful managers need to develop a sophisticated political acumen in their relationship with members of the city council, in addition to having effective financial and managerial skills. City managers often have short tenures in a given city. As the political makeup of the council changes, they often decide to pursue a new political agenda. The current manager may represent the old agenda, and thus part of the new direction, the city council may choose to hire a new city manager.